Shalom uvachem rabbi abotai, shalom uvacha. Bezot Hashem, the mirror of tzaddik, Rabbi Pinto, the mirror of my grandfather, Rabbi Moshe, Rabbi Pinto, my kadosh baruch Hu, give each and every one of our holy kila. Bracha v'atzlacha. Siyata d'shmaya gedola.
Amen.
Ve'al mo'ach tukom yizeket kol mirror of Hashem, Rosh Chodesh Elul. Amen. 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 Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu B'at Hashem fulfill all our wishes. Amen. K'ni Yatzon B'ezrat Hashem. We now tell that right now we are Erev Shabbat. But not just Erev Shabbat on a regular week. Erev Shabbat of Rosh Chodesh Elul. Erev Shabbat of the month that we set out to achieve all what we want to change, all what we want to receive for the entire year to come. B'ezrat Hashem. We now tell that there is a fundamental lesson and rule that we all need to hold on and we have to know for the rest of our lives regarding the bracha of the week. And regarding the bracha of Shabbat, we know about what makes the Shabbat so beautiful, like what the Zohar HaKadosh says, that the Kadosh Baruch Hu opens up the wings of the Shekhinah, and the wings of the Shekhinah, they completely spread and cover the world, and by doing so, a person can receive his extra neshama, his neshama yetera. Now we know about everything in life, there is a vessel that could receive it. If you wanted to receive wine, you need a cup. If you want to hold on air in a specific place, you need something that's completely closed. For every single material and for every single thing that exists, there is a specific vessel which is necessary in order to hold it. If it's something very hot, you cannot put it in any vessel because it will melt the vessel. You need a very strong vessel. The same thing about that with spiritual concepts and with spiritual things that exist in our world. Now, Shekhinah is no different. Shekhinah is something that it needs a specific vessel, a specific keli in order for it to dwell within a person. The Zohar HaKadosh says that what is the vessel, what is the keli for the Shekhinah, which is essentially where we receive our second neshama? It is simple. It is simcha. Where a person that does not have simcha, where a person that is full of sadness, where a person that is too stressed with bad thoughts, the Shekhinah cannot dwell within him. Now, Abotai, it's something that we know, but it's also something that Yetzirah knows very well. And that Yetzirah knows that all what he needs to do is to break that vessel that we are in order to not receive the Shekhinah, and a person completely skips a week and does not receive bracha for the entire week, kula. And that's why all the Mekubalim, they say that on Erev Shabbat, what does Yetzirah do? He comes to the person and starts to give him thoughts of sadness. He starts to give him thoughts of stress. He starts to worry about things that are essentially unnecessary. We try to bring a person to a place of an emptiness, that emptiness will cause them to not receive the Shekhinah for the entire week kulo. And that's what we say in Torah, on Shabbat, Lo tevaru esh bekol moshvotechem. Where Yetzirah comes and starts to try to make fire within the home, whether it's between one and his brother, one and his wife, one and his son, one and his daughter, whatever it is. Yetzirah comes and tries to make fire. Abotai, if we want to receive the Shefa and the Bracha for the entire week, we need to know to avoid that. We need to know to not allow Yetzirah to get the hold of us. Because what happens? If Yetzirah on Erev Shabbat gets grasp on us, and he gets us sad, and he makes us think about all this stress and all these things that we can't even do anything because it's Shabbat, and we start to feel like an emptiness within ourselves, like a lack of ability to act, what happens in that moment? What happens, Abishab? A person finds himself in a place, Erev Shabbat comes in, the Shekhinah cannot dwell within him. Like we said last week, the Neshama Yitera gets pushed within him. Motzei Shabbat comes and he feels even emptier, and the entire week that he lives is a week that he did not receive the Bracha that maybe he should have received. That's why Rabotei, we have to be so careful that on Erev Shabbat we push away all the sadness, we push away all the stress, we clean our minds from all the bad things that could exist. A person needs to take all his bad thoughts, whether it's anger, if it's sadness, if it's a lack of motivation, whatever it is, he needs to hide them in his nefesh. He needs to hide them within himself. He needs to completely put them away before Shabbat in order that when he will enter to the Shabbat Kodesh, he will be able to receive the bracha for the entire week kulo. And that about that is what every person needs to do. When he lights the candles of Shabbat, he needs to have in mind that, yes, he's lighting the physical candle of Shabbat that will illuminate his home, but also he's lighting the candle in his nefesh, the light within himself, in order to truly be able to dwell and truly be able to absorb all that Shefa and all that Bacha that exists on Shabbat Kodesh. You know, but the Zohar says something simple. He says, you know, a lot of people, a lot of times, we hear stories, people, they say every Friday night they have a fight. Every Friday night, every Friday there is balagan. Now the real question is, how can we stop that balagan? So Zohar Kosh Rabotei says something that is scary. He says that every single Shabbat, when a person prepares the preparation for the Shabbat, two malachim, they come down to bring down his neshama yetera. Two angels, they come down to bring down his neshama yetera. Zohar Kosh says, now, depending on how that person acts, depending how that person is, if he's happy or if he's sad, those two malachim say a different be'acha for that person. So Zohar Kosh says, if that person is happy and he's smiling and he has light within himself, the good angel, the right angel, gives a be'acha, which the be'acha is that next week will be exactly like this week. With the good side, the good angel on the right side has the opportunity to give a be'acha that the same way this week is good and there's happiness in the Shekhinah, next week will be the same. And the bad angel needs to say Amen. He's forced to say Amen. He needs to have intention for that bracha to be accomplished. Now what happens when a person is in a bad spot, or is in a bad mood, or there's not a keli to receive the Shekhinah? Zohar Kosh says the bad angel is the bracha. What is the bracha? That Be'ezat Hashem next week will be exactly like this week. And the good angel is forced to say what? To say Amen. And he's forced to have intention to what? For the be'acha to be accomplished. Rabotei, let's break the chain. Especially now that we're entering a month of Elul. Let's fix the chain. Let's break this, the habit of being caught into the net of Yetzirah. Let's bring Shabbatot full of Shefa, Shekhinah. And Bat Hashem will bring a year full of Shekhinah and Shefa for the entire year to come. So may HaKadosh Baruch Hu give everyone big bracha v'atzlacha. Amen. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us the kochot to conquer Yetzirah. Amen. And we'll enter to Shabbat like Arayot Kodesh. To be Bat Hashem to receive the Neshama, to receive the Shekhinah, Kedusha, Amen. Shabbat Shalom. And we'll be Rosh Chodesh Tov Mivorach.